contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring, from Austin, Texas, weighing 200 pounds, Paul London.
Tonight, WWE Velocity is being brought to you by Blade Trinity, starring Wesley Snipes, Jessica Biel, Ryan Reynolds, and Triple H, in theaters December 8th.
And by Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, available exclusively for Nintendo GameCube. Log on to WWE.com for your chance to battle WWE superstars and two WWE live events. Protect the light.
And by Remington Titanium Shavers.
And from Japan, weighing in at 200 pounds, Akio.
So here we go, Akio one-on-one with Paul London. Akio, of course, just got done shooting a huge movie over in Austell, Georgia.
Now, wait a minute. Stop right there.
What?
Pump the brakes.
What?
Funaki's 35% Italian. Akio shooting Korean movies in Georgia.
Why are you calling me a
liar? Haruko challenges Tori Wilson to a broad panties
match. That's true. That's true. That's going to happen on SmackDown this week from Greenville, South Carolina. Tori Wilson one-on-one with Haruko in a broad panties match. Whew, thanks for reminding me, Bill. And don't forget, tomorrow morning, Josh Matthews hosting the WWE Experience.
Where am I during that?
I'm with Ivory.
Okay, yeah, I'll be somewhere else.
Akio and Paul London, collar and elbow tie-up. Nice takedown there by Akio. Now both back up to their feet. It's London in the corner. Let's see if we get a clean break from Akio. And we do not. A shove by Akio, a shove right back by Paul London. Here comes London. Kicked to the midsection by Akio, side headlock. Now a hammerlock here by Akio.
And knowing Paul London, he's got a little axe to grind here with the general manager of SmackDown as well. He's been left out of this whole Billy Kidman scenario with Chavo Guerrero. Paul London's got a little problem with Billy Kidman as well, but it looks like London's got to start all over.
It looks like London might be trying to take out his frustrations on Akio. Nice switch there by Akio. Back heel trip, cover. Paul London quickly turned over, allowing Akio to get the side headlock on Paul London.
This might be one of the few times I can remember in recent history where the belts are less important than revenge.
Shoulder tackle there by Akio.
Oh!
And Paul London quickly grabbing the ankle of Akio, floats over into a front face lock. Nice escape there by Akio. London into the ropes. Mushroom stop by Paul London. And now London with a drop kick, and Akio crashes all the way to the floor.
This kid is so agile. He's such an athlete, Paul London. But look at him playing to the crowd. Finish Akio off and move on.
Paul London! Somersault senton over the top rope. Crashing onto Akio. Let's take another look at that.
Paul London up and over onto Akio, and they both crash the floor. Paul London will give up his body.
London doing the right thing, rolling Akio back into the ring. Got caught!
Oh!
Holy sh! Paul London got caught. Here it is again.
Josh, I can't even believe that Paul London is on his feet.
I can't even believe that Paul London's head is attached to his body. Akio spinning heel kick, skins the cat. And Akio, he looks primed now, ready to go.
Paul London just coming off a whole slew of injuries. Referee Jimmy Cordero should step in and take some authority and possibly call this match right now.
Paul London perhaps now with a concussion. Paul London's head was driven like a nail into the mat.
And Akio capitalizing on that move right now by staying around the neck and throat and head of Paul London.
Sure, Akio's got his offense now for the rest of the match. He's going to go after the neck of Paul London, like you just mentioned. Jumping enziguri by Akio. Cover, this one has got to be. No, a kick out by Paul London. How much heart does Paul London have?
I think Paul London, what's going through his mind right now can be only one thing. I'm not leaving again because I'm injured.
And now Akio slapping the head of Paul London. Reversal, Akio into the buckle. Here comes London. Akio gets the boot up.
Oh!
And a jumping sidekick by Paul London.
And now it's almost an even playing ground because Akio's taking a shot to the head.
Both superstars are down. Akio and Paul London move for move in this great matchup.
Every time you see these two young cruiserweights in the ring, they throw something else at you.
London ducks, drops off by Paul London. What an exchange by Paul London and Akio.
That could have been the best exchange. Wow, I've seen it in a long time.
Moonsault, got him. Akio's gonna win on a kick out by London.
And look at the disbelief on Akio after going toe-to-toe with Paul London, still kicking out of the moonsault.
The knees of Akio crashed right into the head of Paul London, and he still had the kick out. A kick right to the face by London.
I'm going on record right now saying I don't care if there's a winner. This is the best damn match I've seen in a long time.
It's not about titles. It's about two men getting to the ring and going one-on-one, as you can see by the chest of Paul London. London's up on the top rope. If he hits this, it's going to be no.
Oh.
Akio perhaps sensing the end, knocking the ankle of Paul London off that top rope.
A human chess game going on right now, Junior.
And now Akio perhaps going up for that top rope Hurricane Rana. Paul London firing back. These two men know each other very, very well. London shoots off Akio. DDT!
Oh, God!
DDT by Paul London! And this five-star match is over. Bill, I think this match deserves a turning point, a hard-fought match from two combatants.
Josh, the turning point should have been when Paul London hit the ropes and landed on his head, but it's not, because Paul London had enough guts and enough wits about him to get up and hit the Keo with the flying DDT for a big win for Paul London.
It doesn't get much better than the match you just saw